Presenting History's Best on PBS. Tonight on People's Century, 1951. Destroyed by war, Japan transforms itself into an economic superpower. Korea would soon follow. But many are unwilling to trade personal freedom for prosperity. Asia Rising, just one in a series of extraordinary films that explores our century. People's Century, tonight.
In 1964, the opening of the world's first high-speed railway and the staging of the Olympic Games in Tokyo showed just how far the Japanese had come. Though their recovery had been skillfully directed from the top, there'd been a consensus that the economy had to come first. Japanese were encouraged to think of themselves as one big homogeneous family sharing the same goals.
We had a strong desire to be number one in the world. That might sound arrogant, but the words number one in the world were often used. We hated to be behind any other country.
The same emperor who'd announced Japan's surrender in 1945 welcomed the world to a new democratic Japan. Of all the visiting athletes, few were as impressed as those who came from other Asian nations. The South Koreans arrived with a team of 200. Their own country, though Japan's closest neighbor, was still living in a different era. The son of a peasant who grew bean sprouts, Jang Chang-sun was one of the wrestlers.
I was a country boy, and I was arriving in Tokyo for the first time. It seemed like a paradise to me as a young man. There were lots of tall buildings, there were highways, there were overpasses, things you couldn't see in Korea.
Japan's gross national product had overtaken European countries to make Japan's economy the third largest in the world, after the United States and the Soviet Union. Like most other visitors during the Olympic year, the South Koreans wondered how the Japanese had done it.
We had the same circumstances. They experienced the Second World War, and we had the Korean War. Their country was left in ruins, and so was ours. But they were a lot more diligent than we were. When we went one step, they went four or five steps. So it was no surprise that we were 40 or 50 years behind.
In the finals, Chang's opponent was Japanese, giving the match a special edge. The Koreans had no particular liking for the Japanese, who had occupied and ruled Korea in the decades before the war.
I had to win because I was up against a Japanese. I wanted to achieve a miracle, but I lost by 1 point.
Chang 선수는 조국의 명예를 걸고 끝까지 잘 싸워서 레슬링 한국의 명예를 만방에 떨친 것입니다.
Korea had been part of the Japanese Empire for 35 years. But liberation from Japanese rule in 1945 didn't bring the better life Koreans had hoped for. The country had been split in two, a communist regime in the north and an American-backed democracy in the south. An isolated agricultural people, they lacked Japan's industrial tradition. Then in 1950, they were swept into a civil war between North and South. While the Japanese had made money from their neighbor's war, the Koreans suffered on a massive scale. 3 million were killed. As fighting raged up and down the peninsula, millions more became refugees. When Seoul, the southern capital, was about to fall to the communists, Kwak Man-young and his family joined the thousands desperate to leave on the last train.
There were so many people pushing and shoving, trying to get on the train. The train was full of arms and ammunition, so people had to sit on the roof. While we were trying to climb on, we heard two or three North Korean shells go off. The situation became chaotic. My sister and her child scrambled on. The train suddenly lurched forward, but I couldn't get on. I shouted to her, "Let's meet in Busan. Don't die. Stay alive."
At the end of the war, the two sides were left almost precisely where they'd begun, and much of the country had been destroyed. The prospects for the South Koreans looked worse than ever. Kim Bok-soon tried to survive in a makeshift hut near Seoul.
Our clothes were all torn. You could see our bare skin. They were filthy, and we couldn't even wash them. That's how we lived, and people got sick. There were a lot of beggars asking for food. I had to beg for food myself. I had children to feed. So I begged and scavenged for things in the street. That's how difficult it was to live.
The war left South Korea one of the poorest countries in the world. The average per capita income was only $67, less than India or Ghana. South Koreans lived under constant threat of renewed fighting from the North. Business and politics were corrupt, and the country lurched from crisis to crisis. But South Koreans were about to be thrown into changes far more rapid and convulsive than anything the Japanese had lived through. In 1961, a group of military officers